Okay, so as of yesterday, August 16th, China seems to have gotten back into their early release scheduling for the second half of Friendship is Magic. Basically, yesterday they released episode 21, which is the final Daring Do episode. However, their early release scheduling is a lot more different than it was previously a few weeks ago. You see, a few weeks ago, China would air back-to-back new episodes. However, starting as of yesterday, that's not going to be the case. Instead, the scheduling goes like this. They had the new episode, the Daring Do episode, episode 21, yesterday. Now, you would think they would air another new episode, episode 22, today, right? No. They're actually holding off until the end of the month. The very last day of the month, August 31st, is when they're doing it. Is when they're airing that episode on the on-demand service. Which means 15 days from yesterday, 14 days from today. Now, that's not going to be the only time they do a two-week gap. After that, the next time they air a new episode on demand, unless things change, will be on September 13th. And then after that, things go back to a regular weekly release schedule. So, September 13th would be episode 23. September 20th would be the Big Mac question, which is episode 24. And then the 27th would be the two-part finale. That's how China has it set up for the remainder of the second half of Friendship is Magic. Now, on the YouKu, like it's kind of like Ruko, but it's called YouKu, on the YouKu on-demand service. That's how they kind of have it set up. And yes, I am doing this unscripted and on the fly. But I'm sure a lot of people are going to be asking why, and I have two reasonings. The first one is I think someone at Hasbro, DHX, AllSpark Animation had a talk with them, called them up, probably said they appreciate them airing the episodes, but probably requested that they slow down a little bit so that everybody else can kind of have time to catch up, and that perhaps when we get to the finale that there won't be so many spoilers or whatever. Again, just an assumption. Assumption and speculation on that reasoning. The other reasoning being the fact that, you know, China has this upcoming nationalism kind of event involving television programming, showing history and all that about the country and everything. So I'm assuming they had to rearrange things to work around that. Those are two reasons. Those could be two ways of looking at it. Now, China's not the only ones to throw their hat or throw their name into the early release hat. Nope. Our old friends from down under, Australia, are doing the same thing. Australia's doing the same thing, but they're doing it by going a little old school, and we're talking old school weekday morning / afternoon ways. In other words, starting August 22nd, Australia's UTV, I'm guessing that's what it's called, is going to be releasing The Last Laugh, which came out 2 weeks ago. And then the following day, which is the 23rd, and that's a Friday, they'll be releasing last week's episode, 246 Great. And then, I'm assuming on the 26th, they'll be airing A Trivial Pursuit, which was today's episode here in the U.S., which means on the 27th, that being episode 17, I believe, I think it's episode 17, yeah, it is episode 17, is the Summer Setback. So they'll be releasing that on Tuesday, August 27th, if things work out the way they do. And then on Wednesday, August 28th, they'll be releasing the 18th episode, which is She Talks to Angel. And then on the 29th, they'll be releasing Dragon Dropped, which is episode 19. And then episode 20 will be on August 30th, and that is A Horse Shoe-In. And then September 2nd, episode 21, the Daring Do episode, which aired early in China yesterday, will air on September 2nd. The 22nd episode, which is Growing Up is Hard to Do. The Cutie Mark Crusaders episode will air on the 3rd of September, which is a Tuesday. And then on the 4th of September, which is a Wednesday, we get the, so far, as far as we know, untitled episode 23. And then on the 5th of September, which is a Thursday, we get episode 24, which is the Big Mac question. And then on the 6th, and possibly the 9th, we will get the two-part finale. We will either get part 1 on the 6th and part 2 on the 9th, the 6th being a Friday, the 9th being a Monday, or we'll get both of them back-to-back on the 6th. That's basically how Australia has their early release schedule set for the second half of the season. So what we assumed originally at first several weeks ago of China being the ones that could end up ending the series or finishing up the series before this month is out or at the end of this month, pretty much Australia has taken that crown and now they will be the ones to finish off the series unless things change at the beginning of September. So, very interesting change in the early release scheduling and who or what country will be the ones who finish off the series first, or what portions of those countries will be the ones that finish off the series first. So, yeah, basically to reiterate, long story short, to kind of, you know, not make it too long, make this audio video too long, China is going to wrap up the series, unless things change, by the 27th of September, with the way they're doing the scheduling, the release scheduling now. In Australia, unless things change, have a targeted date of September 6th and possibly September 9th to wrap up the series as well. So I just thought I'd come on here and pass that along to you guys. You know, give me your thoughts on it. What are your thoughts on China's early release schedule change or the change to the early release scheduling of the episodes? Give me your thoughts on Australia now suddenly jumping in and being the ones to possibly finish off the series before it's all said and done. Comment down below. I'd love to hear what you guys have to say about it. And that's about all. So talk to you all later. God bless. Take care.